Okay, everybody, so here we are at it again with the FPV stuff. I got most of my equipment in, I got my airplane in, and I'm just waiting for the chain link UHF system to come in. Let's take a look at what I have going on here. So over here, this is the base station. That's the DVD player that maybe eventually I'll get goggles that I can wear on my head. That's the LiPo battery that I have plugged into the receiver unit here, which is plugged into this patch antenna. The receiver unit is using 1.3 gigahertz, and I'm not sure why I chose it. I mean, there's a few different frequencies you can use out there, but it seemed like 1.3 was the best for me. So that's my base unit there, also with my DX8 transmitter here. And this is what's going to be in the plane. So we have the motor, of course. So this is the entire plane laid out on the table without the actual airplane, all the electronics. And we're going to test them here today to make sure that everything works and everything looks good. So let's go over it real quick. This is the motor. So this is the electric motor that I bought for the airplane. It's the one that was recommended on BEVRC.com, along with the matching speed controller. This is a 45 amp with a 3 amp BEC on that. This is the sensor that plugs into the on-screen display that tells me how many voltages, how many milliamp per hour my engine battery, so my motor battery, is using. So this battery right here is going to be used exclusively just to power the motor. It's not going to power the servos, the receiver, or anything, just the motor, okay? The battery I have going here is going to be a 4S 6,000 milliamp hour, so it's going to be a big, beefy 4-amp battery, or 4-cell battery. It can power this motor here for hopefully upwards of an hour or so. Sensor here, this voltage sensor, is going to send the information to your on-screen display. Now, this is really like the heart of your whole system. This is what puts the writing on the display when we turn it on, and this is what really keeps track of the GPS information and all the information on the on-screen display. Two things plugged into the front of it here. One is a GPS reset switch. So this is a switch that you put on the outside of the airplane that you press, and what it does is resets your GPS information, basically how far you are from, you know, where you are right now, how many feet above ground, or how fast. It kind of resets everything, so right before you take off, you want to push this button. The other thing is a GPS receiver. So this is a small blue GPS receiver plugged into the on-screen display, and this is how it's going to calculate how fast I'm going and other moving information. So we go back to the on-screen display here, and in the back of it we have two wires coming out here. One goes to the receiver unit, or the transmitter rather. So here's the video transmitter. One of the wires from the on-screen display goes here, and this gets attached to the airplane. This is what talks to this over here with that antenna on the ground. So this is your ear unit that goes in the airplane, and the video signal is pumped into, comes from the on-screen display, goes to the transmitter, and transmits everything over to the receiver. The other wire here coming out of the on-screen display is where first you get your power from. So this is your power unit. I'll get more into that in a little bit. So you plug your power into the OS on-screen display here, and that's where the on-screen display gets its power. But I also have a 10-amp BEC plugged into the battery as well, and this is what actually powers my receiver. Okay, so I'm powering my receiver from my second battery. This battery is going to be powering my 1.3 gigahertz transmitter here, my on-screen display down here, and also my receiver. Okay, so and then the other battery powers exclusively the motor. So this battery here, I'm probably going to use a 3-cell, maybe 1800 or 2200 milliamp hour battery there. So what we have down here now, this is my AR6210 that I'm using right now for the 2.4 gigahertz system. And I have the BEC power coming in, and I have the throttle connection for the speed controller of the motor. One thing you want to do or to make sure is that you take out the center wire, which is this red wire, on the speed controller before you plug it into the receiver, because you don't want two powers to go into the receiver here. It'll blow it up. So you want to disconnect the power wire from the speed controller, because you're getting your power from the 10 amp BEC there. So we go from the receiver into the FY-21AP. And now what the FY-21AP is that it's an autopilot, and it has some really cool functions to it. What it can do is you can fly your airplane out while looking at the screen. And if your plane ever gets out of range, the failure code is to basically turn the plane around and fly it back to you. So it circles above your head and waits for you to gain control of it. So another feature that it has is, so that's called return to home, meaning it returns to home, it returns to you if you flip a switch or if you get out of range. Another feature it has is it can keep the plane flying at a certain altitude, so you don't have to worry about ups and downs. You just fly left and right, so you're not worried about, am I going in a downward motion or an upward motion? It controls up and down, so you can fly freely and just do the left and right. So it's going to work really well. We're going to test it here this afternoon, so you'll see some of that here in just a minute. So attached to the FY-21AP is another GPS receiver. And this GPS receiver is used to do like the return to home thing, where it has to keep track of where it is and where it's going, and that type of information. And that's where you connect your servos to, actually directly to the FY-21AP, and then that connects to your actual receiver, and then the receiver goes 2.4 gigahertz back to your DX8. So I hope I didn't go that fast there for you. What we're going to do now is just plug it all in and hope it works. So I already have my transmitter turned on, and I'm going to just plug my main motor battery and my receiver OSD and my radio receiver power in, and let's see what happens. So let's give it a shot. My motor. That's everything else. Okay, so we're looking good right now. We're looking good. So we have the, I didn't show you the camera. Okay, so the other wire coming out of the on-screen display here goes to this camera. The camera just goes back here, and it's sitting right there. So it's a small NTSC camera. It's, I think, 540 lines. It wasn't the bottom of the grade. It was maybe in the middle. It seems to work really well. So there's some video. So we know the system's actually working. If we look at the information on the screen, we can see there in the left side, this is your AV. It says AV there, and that's how many volts your AV battery has. And this says engine. And 12.5, and that's how much your engine battery has. So it reports back both battery voltages. And also down here, it actually shows you what your engine milliamp hour draw is on that battery. Right here is basically how many feet you are away, how far the plane is away from you. And right here is just like a compass. Where you can know whether you're going north, east, south, west. Down in the bottom right, it tells you how long you've been flying for, how many feet the airplane is at, miles per hour, and feet per second. Right now, this thing is flashing here, which tells me it's trying to get a GPS signal. So we're going to come back here, and we're just going to take a look at the system here. Now let's see if the motor will power up here. Yep, that motor powers up. So everything's working properly. The on-screen display, the receiver. Now let me try some... okay, so the servos are working. Now, when the stabilizer is turned on, as it is right now, when the FY-21AP moves, it'll force the servos to straighten the plane out. So if I just move the FY-21AP, it's attempting to straighten the airplane out. So if this was in the airplane and the airplane went down or up or left or right, it's attempting to correct by moving the servos automatically so that the airplane stays in a straight motion. Or I can do it manually, but that's really cool. I'm really digging that. That's going to be really the brain of the whole system, along with the on-screen display there. So that's about it for now. I'm at about 11 minutes. I hope you guys enjoyed my little video here. I got more in-depth on the FPV stuff. If you have any questions or you don't understand it or, if I can help, just let me know. I want to give a couple shout-outs today. One is going to be to Wet Movie One. I watch his videos. He's really cool. He does lots of movie reviews and whatnot. And his buddy, Hero Super 99. Make sure you check out those guys. Also, Cool Duder is a good movie reviewer and a video guy. I watch him all the time. Also, just so you know, too, I do use Twitter a lot. So I'll do like Twitter feeds. About stuff that I'm interested in, and maybe you're interested in them too. So follow me on Twitter. And one last thing, mylivechickens.com is going to be updated. So my chicken videos are going to come out, and my live videos, mylivechickens.com is the site you want to go to check out all the new stuff that's coming up. And I'm going to fly my trainer over the river soon, so we're going to get a video of that. My trainer, my Tower Trainer 40 with the 46 motor on the front of it. I put two big Hangar 9 40 size balsa floats on it, and we're going to take it over the river pretty soon here, so we'll have a video of that out real soon. Thanks guys for watching. I know I'm rambling, but I appreciate you watching my videos. Definitely give me a thumbs up if you can, and we will talk to you again very soon. Thanks.